أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي Dear children, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hope that you all will be very fine, inshallah. Well, today is our first session in which we will discuss our first chapter and we will revise it in a very brief, inshallah. As we all know that we have completed this chapter in our class, money. So we'll talk about today's this chapter. But we will not go in the detail. We'll just study the basic concept and very few topics about this chapter. So we have to cover these four topics basically. Today we'll talk about expressing the money. How can we express the money? We can express the money in words. We can express the money in figures. Second, we'll talk about how to add the money. That's addition of money. Third, we'll talk about the subtraction of money, means how to subtract the money. Fourth thing that we have to discuss over here is that how that the conversion, that how to convert the rupees into money, how to convert the rupees into money. But before going in detail about all these four topics, first we should know that money can be in the form of coins and it can be in the form of note. Money can be in the form of coins and it can be in the form of note. Okay. Now, how to identify that which rupee coin or which rupee note is it? It's very easy. See, on every coin or on every note, the number will be written over there. For example, the number 2 is written over here. It means it is 2 rupee coin. For example, if the number 5 will be written over here, so it will be 5 rupee coin. Now, as the number 10 is written over here, so it is 10 rupee note. As the number 20 is written over here, so it is 20 rupee note. Similarly, as the number 50 is written over here, so it is 50 rupee note. So likewise, all the coins and notes can be identified just by seeing the number which number is written over there. So we can identify it very easily. So I hope that it's very easy for all of you. Okay, now we will go in the detail. Before going in the detail, I want to tell you one thing which you all know, Alhamdulillah. First thing, we all know that 1 rupee is equals to 100 paise. 1 rupee is equals to 100 paise. If I will tell you 2 rupees is equals to what, you will tell me 200 paise. If I will tell you 3 rupees is equals to what, you will tell me 3 rupees is equals to 300 paise. Likewise, 4 rupees is equals to 400 paise. Now, it's very easy. If I will tell you that 12 rupees is equals to what you have to do, you have to just add 2 zeros after the given number. It will be 1200 paise. If I will tell you 20 rupees is equals to what you have to do, you have to add just 2 zeros after this number 20. So it will be 2000 paise. So it's very easy to convert the rupees into paise. Okay, but we can express the rupees, we can express the money in the form of words and figures also. Okay, now if you first we'll talk about the figures, how to express the money in the form of figures. Figures means numbers. Figures means number. For example, if I will write over here 31.42. See, there is a point. So everything which is there at the right side of the point, the number which is at the right side of the point is called as paise. It's called as paise. And the number which is at the left side of the point is called as rupees. The number which is at the right side of the coin, is called as paise. And the number which is at the left side of the point is called as rupees. I hope that this is very clear to you. Okay, now, if I want to write, so this is called as expressing the money in figures. Now, if I will tell you that express this in the form of words, what you have to tell? You will write there 31 rupees 42 paise. Means at the left side it will be rupees. And at the right side of the point, it will be paise. So 31 rupees, 42 paise. One more example. If I will write here 43.50, so it will be 43 rupees and 50 paise. You have to write in words 43 rupees
43 rupees 50 paise.
Once again, I want to repeat that whatever is there at the right side of the point will be paise, and whatever is there at the left side of the point, whichever number is there at the left side of the point, will be rupees. Now, you have to remember one thing, that if I will tell you the paise from 1 to 9, if I will tell you paise from 1 to 9, then you have to, and if you want to express this in the form of figures, that is in the form of numbers, so you have to write 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, 6, 0, 7, 0, 8 and 0, 9 like this. For example, if I will tell you, write
4 rupees 3 paise
in figures. Figures means number.
So how will you write? You will write the rupees sign. Now 4 point,
it's 3. I told you whenever the paise will be from 1 to 9. Whenever the paise will be from 1 to 9, so you will write it as after point 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, 6, 0, 7, 0, 8 and 0, 9. Now it is 3, it is from 1 to 9, so you will write it as 0, 3. So 4 rupees and 3 paise, 4 rupees, 3 paise. If you will not write it like this, means 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, so it will be wrong. How?
If you will not write it like this, and so if so, obviously you will write it like this, 4.0.
So the meaning of this rupee will not be 4 rupees, 4, sorry. The meaning of this rupees will not be 4 rupees 3 paise, rather the meaning of this will be 4 rupees 30 paise. So you should be very active in writing the rupees and paise while you will express in the form of figures. Once again, I'm repeating, if it is from 1 to 9, so you have to write after point 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5 like that.
One more example, if I will tell you, write 40 rupees. 40 rupees 6 paise. So how will you write? Rupee sign 40 point, as it is from 1 to 9, so 40.06.
Okay, I hope that it is clear.
Now, if I will tell you write 40 rupees 60 paise, so how will you write? You will write the rupee sign, you will write the 40, you will write the point.
Now, it is not from 1 to 9. 60 is not the number which is from 1 to 9. 60 wo number nahi jo 1 se 99 tak ka hai. Ye uske aage ka hai. So, jab kabhi bhi 1 se 9 ke aage ka number aayega, means 10, means you can say 2 digit number aayega. To us waqt aapko directly likhna hai 60.
Is waqt abhi aap isko aisa kar doge 40.06.
40.060. So, it will be wrong. Iska matlab ho jayega 40 rupees 6 paise. तो आपको carefully आपको केयर करना है. Whenever you will write the paise, you should check whether it is from 1 to 9, means it is one digit, or it is after 9. Okay,
now it was the expressing the money in the form of figures and words.
Now how to add the money? Addition is also very easy. You all know that how to add the normal numbers. The addition of the numbers is the addition of the money is just like the addition of the basic numbers. For example, you will be given like this, add
43.65 and 40.30. One example,
you can also be given it like this,
add paise rupees 45 will be here, 65 will be here, 40 will be here and 30 will be here.
You can be given the question in any of these two formats. First format is add rupees 46.65 and 40.30, means 40 rupees 30 paise. Now how you have to add? You have to add this in the form of this question format. Now the second question is add rupees paise is given, rupees is given over here, paise is given here, given over here.
So if you want to add this question, you have to express in the form of vertical columns. Now we talk about this question.
It was at rupees 45.65 paise and 40 rupees is 30 paise. Now how will you add it?
You will make the two columns. First will be of paise, second will be of rupees. You will write here 45, you will write here 65, you will write here 40, and you will write here 30. You will write the addition sign. Now 5 plus 0, 5, 6 plus 3, 9, 5 plus 0, 5, 4 plus 4, 8.
Your answer is 85 rupees 95 paise. 85 rupees 95 paise.
So I hope that this will be very clear to you. Now if I will give you the same question, and if I will tell you subtract.
So what have you to do? You have to write here,
paise, rupees below rupees, paise below paise, rupees below rupees, paise below paise. Now sign of subtraction is there.
One point should be, means one case should be given over here that one's number should be below one's number, one's number should be below one's number. Oh, sorry, tens number should be below tens number. One's number below should one's number and tens below tens. Okay, this care should be given while adding or subtracting.
Now 5 minus 0, 5, 6 minus 3, 3, 5 minus 0, 5, 4 minus 0, 4 minus 4, 0.
So your answer is 5 rupees 35 paise. 5 rupees 35 paise. So I hope that this will also be clear to you. Now conversion of rupees into paise. Actually, we have already completed this topic at the very beginning. When I was explaining you that 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise, at the time we have covered this topic. But once again, we will understand this topic separately. Now the fourth topic is conversion of rupees into paise. Now how to convert the rupees into paise?
See, we all know that 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise.
We all know that 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. So if anyone will tell you that convert
rupees 13 into paise.
So it's very easy. See, how will you write?
You will write here 13. Rupees 13 is equal to, write here 13, write the multiplication sign.
We all know that 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise.
So multiply it with 100, write here 13.
Now after one how many zeros are there? Two zeros.
Add two zeros. So you have converted the rupees into paise.
One more example, if anyone will tell you,
convert 49 rupees into paise.
Same method you will follow.
You will write here rupees 49 equal to 49 multiplication.
We know that 1 rupees is equal to 100 paise.
Multiplied by 100 equal to, write 49 as it is.
How many zeros are there after 1? 2 zeros.
Write there 2 zeros. So 4900 paise.
So 49 rupees is equal to 4900 paise. Now, if I will tell you
we will take one more example. If I will tell you how to convert 9000 rupees into paise,
so how will you do?
You will write rupees 9000 equals to 9000 as it is. We know that 1 rupee is equals to 100 paise, multiply it with 100 equals to 9000. Write 9000 as it is. Now after 1, how many zeros are there?
2 zeros.
Add 2 zeros. It will be converted into paise.
So easy. So the basic concept is, if you want to convert rupees into paise, you have to just add 2 zeros after the given rupees. You have to just add 2 zeros after the given rupees. It was 9000 rupees. You added 2 zero. It became paise. It get converted into paise. It's very easy. Once again, I'm repeating. If you want to convert rupees into paise, just multiply it by 100 and write 2 zeros as it is after the given number. Hope that this will be very clear to you. And best of luck to all of you. May Allah succeed you in your future life, inshallah. And if you have any doubts, you can ask. Means you can communicate with me, with sir, and he will communicate with me, inshallah. I will get your doubts cleared, inshallah. Remember in dua and pray the namaz regularly. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.